Welcome back to the NDTV Vedanta Our Girls, Our Pride campaign. We do have with us two very special guests now joining in. Ayushman Khurrana, actor, singer, I don't know what all he does. Ayushman.
He doesn't leave anything for anybody.
Yeah, everything. Well, you know, and nobody sounds like will. Somebody I know not very sitting very far, very far from me. So there you are.
Well,
so,
okay. Nobody will forget his part in Vicky Donor, definitely.
Right. And of course, Shana Hussain, it's great to have you with us as well. It's such a pleasure that you could join us. Thank you both so much for being with us.
And who doesn't know Shehnaz, ma'am? Of course, everybody knows the epitome of beauty, somebody who has always brought about and made women in India feel beautiful by just being naturally themselves.
Well put.
I love Shehnaz Hussain, okay?
Okay. Ma'am, why don't you start? We've been hearing all through the day the extent to which gender discrimination is still continuing. And in certain pockets, it's not there. But by and large, there's still massive gender discrimination. What do you think we can do about it?
I think the most important value that we must understand and educate the public is A, the value of a girl in the family. When a girl is born, the celebration must be as much as when the boy is born. We must value the girl by way of education. When there's an option to educate the boy and the girl, the natural thought would be, because the boy is a breadwinner, to educate the boy first. Great importance must be placed on education. Then empowerment of the girl as she grows up, she must learn to value her fact that she is an important aspect of society and she contributes, and she must be valued in the family as much as the boy. Apart from that, the most important thing is education. As Mahatma Gandhi said, if you educate a man, you educate an individual. You educate a woman and you educate a family. Education is very important, very, very important. Valuing the fact that she's a girl must be kept in mind. Then the thought process of the public must change as far as the woman is concerned. She must be kept in the same aspect of importance as a boy.
Right. Well said.
Well said. But ma'am, if I could just ask you, what you're saying is the way it should be. But unfortunately in our country right now, and at least in large parts of our country, far from valuing the girl, you have one out of every six girls who will die because of gender discrimination. And those are just frightening statistics. The reality is very far from what the ideal should be, unfortunately.
After 66 years, we still need to value the girl child. We need to value the fact that she's a woman. We mean to value the fact that she's a very important aspect of society. Her position in the house is as important, maybe more important than a man. But then the men also must be educated to value the woman, value the fact that she's there for them and for taking society and the family ahead. I think the actual public needs to be educated on the value of a woman in society, in life, in the future of the progress and the future of the country. That is important. Education of the man is important for him to value the woman, to value the girl child and celebrate as much the fact that there's a woman in the house, a girl in the house, as it is when you celebrate a man or a boy.
Absolutely. And on that note, I would like to speak to Ayushman and I would like to ask you, you know, as a boy yourself, what do you think that the mindset of men in this country needs to be or should be for women to flourish?
I think as a boy or maybe as a parent, one should sensitize the men, the boys in the family. And apart from that, I would like to say that I'm sitting in Panchkula right now, which comes under Haryana, which is like 2 kilometers away from the Western Command, Chandni Mandir. And Priyanka, you must be knowing about the Western Command.
Yes, being of course, I've stayed in
Chandni
Mandir.
So yeah, I can talk about the state as of now that, you know, yeah, so the sex ratio of the state is quite lopsided, 870s to 1000. And this is the state where parda system is still prevalent. And in some areas of Haryana, like south and southern western areas, the child marriage is also there. So resistance from society towards educating girl child, towards female literacy. But post 2006, I think the things have really changed. And the state has gone beyond the expectations of the Right to Education Act 2009. And by providing free girl education, free uniforms, free textbooks, and there's not even a single child in this state which has to travel for more than 1 kilometer to reach a classroom. And the number of females have increased in the classroom because of two main reasons. One, the transport system has become better and females feel safer while commuting. And number two, they've opened some bachpan shalas, which we casually call creches for infants, which relieves the older girls of certain responsibilities back home, and it gives them free time to study. But of course, there are certain loopholes by since there's some issue with the recruitment of teachers and stuff like that. But I think the situation is much better. And this is the state where there are women achievers like Santosh Yadav, who climbed the Mount Everest, and late Kalpana Chawla. I'm sure the girls, the young girls, they draw inspiration from these women.
But, you know, having said that, it's some of those states, you know, Punjab, Haryana, Himachal, which traditionally have been perhaps one of the biggest offenders, if you like, in it comes to things like declining sex ratios. And it hasn't, the education levels haven't made a difference. High prosperity levels haven't made a difference. We often hear things like, you know, now that girls can inherit land and can inherit property, there's a desire to kill off some baby girls just because, you know, we don't want to subdivide our piece of land too much. So those are still some of the horror stories that still come out from that area.
Yeah, there, of course, Haryana was traditionally known as one of the in lower levels of human indices. But there's one great example of IIM Rohtak, where these students, they discovered that lot of female students were dropping out of school after class 5 because of household chores. And they also discovered that the auto walas, the auto rickshaw was the most common mode of public transportation in Rohtak. And they saw that these auto walas were also not well-to-do, and they were still hand-to-mouth. So they discovered a plan. They devised a plan where they used these autos as a mode of transit slash outdoor advertising, and they got revenue out of them, and they supported the daughters of auto walas, and rest of the money was spent in the repairs of autos. So they devised a brilliant plan with this, and a lot of mid-sized businesses were supporting these autowalas and were going for these advertising plans. And State Bank of India was sponsoring them. And there are a lot of computer institutes which are giving free education, computer training to girls in Rohtak. I think it's a great positive sign in a state which is traditionally known as, you know, being part of the lower social indices.
Well, like Ayushman said and Shehnaz ma'am both said, there's a lot to be done and there's a lot that can be done.
Absolutely. And, you know, Ayushman, I can't resist asking you this question. We have, you know, again in Haryana, there are issues which we'll be coming to, I think, in half an hour or so. Some of the Kha panchayats out there are really, the attitudes they have to women and to girls is quite shocking.
And we're going to be speaking to one of them in our next segment.
We're going to be speaking to somebody there just in a short while from now. And also, what also happens out there is that the way mothers are sometimes treated when they have a girl child. Now, there should be no discrimination when the girl child comes. But as you might well know from Vicky Doner, I'm sure you researched the subject, at the end of the day, it's the father who determines the sex of the child, not the mother.
And that is something.
Feel free to elaborate on that in any detail that you want.
Yeah. Okay, I've written a poem. I've written a poem in Hindi on a girl child. In fact, it just summarizes what a girl, average girl, in our country goes through. And it's called Ek Ladki Aisi Hai Jo Bachpan Mein Badi Ho Gayi. Should I go for it?
Yes, please.
Please, go ahead.
I think ये NDTV India के जो audience है वो ज़्यादा समझ पाएंगे कि बहुत ही गहरी हिंदी का इस्तेमाल किया है इसमें मैंने।
हाँ, जैसे हम
समझ पाएंगे। एक लड़की ऐसी है जो बचपन में बड़ी हो गई। Of course आप समझ पाएंगे।
बोलो बोलो please।
चलिए मैं कहाँ कविता का शीर्षक है एक लड़की ऐसी है जो बचपन में बड़ी हो गई। एक लड़की ऐसी है जो बचपन में बड़ी हो गई। शोर से इस रोजमर्रा में अनसुनी सी ध्वनि हो गई, हल्के फुलके कंधों पर एत्व से सनी हो गई, भागते से जीवन में रुकी सी खड़ी हो गई, आंखों से छुटपन में क्षण में घड़ी हो गई, कभी हंसी में बहती एक अश्रु की बूंद मल्हार सी लड़ी हो गई, पुरुष के छोटे पौरुष की बड़ी सी तड़ी हो गई, नर अहंकार के मरुस्थल में घास की पत्ती सी हरी हो गई, सैकड़ों मर्द दानवों में नन्ही सी परी हो गई, अल्पायु की वायु में भी गोद कुछ भरी हो गई, आज ना फिर पढ़ पाए वो इस बात की कड़ी हो गई, एक लड़की ऐसी है जो बचपन में बड़ी हो गई।
Wow, Ayushman, as you started by saying, is there anything which you cannot do? We're going to think, maybe.
I think he can do everything. Please, I've told him that 100 times before.
The Indian football team, maybe, or something like that. I have to try and think
I'm
of something
not a Superman,
else.
I'm just
kabaddi.
Kabaddi, yeah. Priyanka's taking up kabaddi, so maybe we should think about that.
Shehnaz, ma'am, jaane se pehle bas main aapse poochna chahungi ki, you know, you've been such an icon to women, and women have always looked up to you. Any last message for the girl child?
Well, I think the most important thing that I advise every woman is to finally work towards financial independence. If she's financially independent, then no power on earth can either downtrodden her or make her less than anybody else. She must make herself financially independent. At no stage in life should she look up to anybody to look after her. She must be financially, as a woman entrepreneur, being able to look after herself. If she's financially independent, she has no problem now or ever in the future.
Well, on that note, financially independent women, thank you so much for joining us, Shehnaz ma'am and Ayushman. Thank you very much.
Thank you both. So-